Welcome to Learn It. Today, we'll be taking the topic 2 of physical education, class 12. If you have not seen the first topic, I suggest you to click on the I button card shown on the logo of Learn It in the right top corner. I hope if you are moving forward with the video, you might have already seen it. Let us have a small revision. We have already learned about some of the topics such as meaning and objective of planning, various committees, for example, committee for publicity, transport committee, boarding and lodging committee, etc. Tournament and importance of it, types and advantages and disadvantages of tournament, types of combination tournament such as knockout tournament, knockout come league tournament, league come league tournament, and league come knockout tournament. And we have also seen some of the examples of the combination tournament. So, without wasting more time, let's start with the second topic. The first topic we will be taking today is fixtures. Any tournament, whether it is knockout or league, is arranged according to a set procedure, which is known as fixtures. For knockout tournament, the procedure to draw fixture is through bye and seeding. And for league tournament, the procedure to draw fixtures is through staircase and cyclic method. Fixture is the process of arranging the teams in systematic order in various groups for competition in a physical activity. In other words, it is the setup of various teams for competitive matches where they play in a systematic order as per the fixture schedule. The success of a tournament depends upon planning of suitable fixtures. Tournaments are played in various forms of fixtures that we will be looking in the next page. As we have already seen, the fixtures in knockout tournament are of two types. One is seeding and second one is byes. Now we will move on to more detail of seeding. What does the seeding mean? Seeding is a procedure by which good teams are placed in fixtures in such a way that stronger teams do not meet each other at a very start of the tournament. It is done to overcome the drawbacks of a single knockout tournament. Seeding can be done only if the standard of the teams are known before the start of the tournament. The draw may result between the strong competitors at early level competition, so they are seeded to prevent this. Thus, the top competitors will not meet until the quarterfinal, semi-final or final rounds. Seeding is used to ensure that players or team of recognized outstanding ability do not confront each other in the early round. It represents the tournament committee's subjective rating of the various players and chances of winning the tournament. There is also a special case of seeding which is known as special seeding. It is a method of seeding in which the players or team directly participate in the quarterfinal or semi-final matches, thus avoiding their participation in the initial rounds. Now let's talk about second method, which is bye method. Bye means the avoiding of playing a match in the first round of the tournament. It is a privilege given to team which is decided generally by seeding it or by draw of lots. Some teams may get bye in first round by which they get promoted to the higher round competition. This may be given as a reward for their some previous achievements. Bias can be applied equally to the single person competitions and team sports as well, to single game eliminations and best of series elimination. Bias are given in first round only. The number of bias that should be given in a tournament is decided by finding the difference between the number of team and the next power of 2. For example, let us take n minus 1. If 20 teams are participating, then total 19 matches will be there. For example, if n is the total number of teams, for this case it is 20. So we'll put it into the formula, which is n is equals to 20. Then the result comes 20 minus 1 is equals to 19. So the 20 team will have 19 matches. Before moving forward, let us look at two things or methods which is important for drawing fixtures in knockout tournament. The first one is how to calculate total number of matches. It is calculated by subtracting 1 from total number of teams. For example, n minus 1, where n is the total number of team. And for this example, we are taking 11 teams as an example. So, if 11 teams are participating, then total 10 matches will be there, because where 11 is written, it is n, which means the total number of teams in this case is 11. So 11 minus 1 is equals to 10. So basically 11 teams will have 10 matches in total. And when we move forward into the next topic, which is number of rounds, which means initial rounds, quarterfinals, semifinals and finals. If number of team is a power of 2, then, for example, if you take 16 teams and to calculate their rounds, it will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, which means 2 to the power 4 will be their total rounds, which means there will be total amount of 4 rounds when 16 teams are playing. So this is the case for even category. If it is a power, by chance, if number of team is not a power of 2, then what? So we'll take another example where it is not a power of 2. For example, we'll take team 21. Then we'll calculate the total number of rounds will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, which is total number of power 5 is there. So there will be 5 rounds, because the next power of 2 in this case is 32. Now we are moving on to one of the important topics of this chapter. If this step gets any mistake, all of the fixture will show some error. Okay, so listen to it carefully and see it on the screen. It is the number of teams in each half. How to divide it? All the teams are divided into two halves for the sake of convenience. If the number of team is even, then the number of teams in upper half and lower half will be equal. For example, the formula will be n by 2, where n is the total number of team. So we'll calculate it for upper half also and for lower half also. For upper half, the formula is n by 2, and for lower half also the formula is same, n by 2. In case if the teams are even, which means the team are 4, 6, 8, etc. So we'll calculate it. The number of teams in upper half, the formula is n by 2, where we all know that n is the total number of teams. Wherever n is there, it determines that it is the total number of team. So the total number of team in this case is 20, which is an even number. So 20 divided by 2 is 10 for the upper half, and it will be same for the lower half. So now in even case, the teams are divided on both parts equally, which means if 20 teams are participating, it will be dividing it into half, which is 10 on the upper side and 10 on the lower side. What in case of odd number then? So let us take an example. If the total number of team is 15, which is not an even number, it is just an odd number, the formula for odd will be n plus 1 by 2 in case of upper half. And in case of lower half, the plus sign changes to minus, which is n minus 1 by 2. I'll repeat it. Formula for odd number of teams, for calculating upper half and lower half, for odd number of teams, it will be, for upper half, it will be n plus 1 by 2, by means divided by 2, and for lower half, it will be n minus 1 divided by 2. Let us take an example here. There it is given total number of teams is 15. Then if we are calculating it for upper half, the formula is n plus 1 by 2. That is 15, which is the total number of team, plus 1 divided by 2. So 15 plus 1 is equals to 16. And when we divide 16 by 2, the answer is 8. So total number of team in upper half will be 8. Now same as we'll be calculating it for the lower half also. Now the total number of teams will be same, which is 15. But a minor change is there. In case of plus in upper half, there will be a minus in lower half. So the formula comes like this: n minus 1 divided by 2, that is 15 minus 1, which is 14, divided by 2 is equals to 7. So in this case, in odd number of cases, upper half and lower half teams will be divided into two unequal parts, which is upper half will have 8 teams and the lower half will have 7 teams. Now let us move to the next topic, which is how to calculate number of byes given. Teams getting the byes do not play in the initial round. They are given by subtracting the number of teams by the next power of 2. Let us take two examples. The example one is, if total number of teams is 19, the next power of 2 after 19 is basically 32. Let us calculate it. How to calculate the power of 2 is, 2 power 1 is 2, 2 power 2 is 4, 2 power 3 is 8, 2 power 4 is 16, and 2 power 5 is 32. So basically, for 19 teams, the highest power nearest to the team 19 is basically 32. Therefore, the number of byes will be 32 minus total number of teams, which is 32 minus 19, is equals to 13. Here, 13 is total number of byes in example 1. Let us take another example where total number of teams will be 12 and next power of 2 after 12 is 16, which is the nearest highest power. Therefore, the number of byes for this category is 16 minus 2, which is highest power, minus total number of teams. Then we'll get 04, which is total number of byes given in example 2 will be only 4. Hence, 13 teams in example 1 and 4 teams in example 2 will not play the match in first round. The next topic is how to place byes in the fixtures. The first bye is given to the last team of lower half. The second bye is given to the first team of upper half. The third bye is given to the first team of lower half. The fourth bye is given to the last team of upper half. The next byes or byes will be given in the same order as described. Now let us calculate a fixture of 12 teams. As we all know that 12 is an even number, so the teams are in even category. So every formula will be given according to the even statement. Now let us take number of teams 12, which is n. Second is, we have to find the number of matches that will be happening in this 12 team fixtures. It will be n minus 1, which is 12 minus 1, we'll get the answer 11. Let us calculate the upper half and lower half for this fixture. The first is upper half and lower half. As we all know that in even number, the formula is n by 2, which means n is equals to total number of teams, which is 12 in this category. 12 divided by 2 is equals to 6 in the upper half and 6 in the lower half. Let us calculate the number of byes. The nearest power for this 12 is 16. So let us consider 16 minus 12, we get total number of byes 4. Now, as we have already decided that to find the number of rounds, we have already had one slide before. You can visit there and you can find out how to calculate the number of rounds. So let us look at the upper half and lower half. There are basically 12 teams. Team number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in upper half and 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 in the lower half. So how are the byes given? As we have already discussed, the first bye will be given to the last team, which is 12th team. The second bye will be given to the first team of the upper half. Third bye will be given to the first team of lower half. And fourth bye will be given to 6th team of upper half. In the first half, or in the first round, the teams which are getting buys will not play the first round, and all other team will directly go or will be as a winner and goes into the second round. The number of teams given by will directly go to the second round, and the winner of first round will play them their matches with the teams who had been given buys. The winner will go into the quarterfinal, then to the semifinal, and the last one will be emerging as a winner. This is the basically fixture of a 12 team. Let us take another example of fixtures of 13 teams. As 13 is an odd number, so we'll first divide the teams into how many matches these teams will play. So basically, we just find out of 13 teams, we'll keep this in formula, which is n minus 1. Then we'll get 13 minus 1 is equals to 12 matches, which means 13 team will play 12 matches. Let us divide this part into upper half and lower half. As this is an odd category, the formula for upper half will be n plus 1 by 2. And for the lower half, it will be n minus 1 by 2. So by getting this formula and n is equals to 13, which is n plus 1, 13 plus 1 divided by 2 is equals to 7. And second is 13 minus 1 divided by 2 is equals to 6. So you can see there, in upper half there is basically 7 teams, and in the lower half there is only 6 teams. Team 1 to 7 is 7 teams, and team 8 to 13 it is only 6 teams. Now we'll decide what are the number of buys to be given. Buys are given on the basis of the closest highest power of 2. So for 13 team, the closest highest power is 16. So we'll take 16, and when we are minusing it from 13, we only get a total number of 3 buys. And buys are given in a sequence which has already been told. First, it is given to the last team of lower half. The second buy is given to the first team of upper half. And it has only 3 buys, that's why the third buy will be given to the lower half of the first team. In the first round itself, we have only 5 winners, and all the other team will get buys. Like, they will be having 3 buys, and all other team will play with each other, and they will directly go to the second round. In second round, they will compete with each other, and they will be only 4 winners. These 4 winners will go to the third round, where they will play semi-finals, and in the fourth round they will play the final, and the winner team or the winning team will be crowned as an winner. So this is the fixture for team 13. That's it for today's video. I hope you have understood the topics very well. But for more understanding, I urge all of you to repeat this video again for clearer understanding. If you like the video and its content, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to comment your name in the comment section. If you are unable to understand or is struggling in any of the topic, please write the topic in the comment section. I'll surely try to get to you soon. So for more of such videos, stay tuned to the channel, stay safe, stay healthy, and don't forget to learn it.